It's time for the Fiend Brian match. The Fiend's tombs are just starting.
Let me in.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we thank you for joining us here tonight at Survivor Series in Chicago, we want to tell you this. If you have not had the opportunity to see this man,
Bray's got the title around his neck. Let's get right into the match. And here we go.
Daniel Bryan is the challenger. Very intense look in the eyes of Bryan.
Red attire, blue belt. Who's never battled anything like this in his career. Let's go.
Daniel Bryan's had issues with
Bryan in the past, but this is not Bray Wyatt. This is the Fiend to take his jacket off.
And look at Bryan go.
Bryan with a roundhouse kick
to the corner. Rapid fire strikes in the corner. Daniel Bryan realizes he cannot relent.
And a drop kick again to the Fiend, keeping Bryan in the corner.
As again, Bryan flies across the
ring. And Bray just with a clothesline turned him inside out.
Bryan on a clothesline of the Fiend. What do you do, Corey? How do you combat this man? There's no answer to that question,
video.
Cole. Nobody's been able to do it yet. Seth Rollins tried to fail. Daniel Bryan is failing
Seth
at the moment. Viz realizes
the
what the Fiend is capable of. There is no answer.
This
you can't
like
solve
the
Fiend.
Jerry
the King
Lawler
here tonight on commentary on some of the matches at Survivor Series. Fiend at one point a couple of months ago. The Fiend has attacked everyone in his path.
We've
seen the Fiend on multiple occasions utilize the mandible claw, paralyzing his opponents. Ask Daniel Bryan about that this past Friday night.
And a head control. And a carnage he is creating.
You mentioned it, Adam. You mentioned it when the Fiend first walked out tonight.
It's
a change in the atmosphere and the environment.
The Fiend was just screaming, "Remember me."
Bryan desperately trying to fight back.
Bryan the face bar. Trying to fight back, Big Urinagi.
Urinagi just plants Daniel Bryan. And we know there is no quit in Daniel Bryan. He will continue to fight, but maybe tonight's the night to find the quit. And you talked about a couple of nights ago on SmackDown what Daniel Bryan accomplished in WrestleMania in one night, the people he beat. Randy Orton, Batista, and Triple H all in one night at WrestleMania. That is amongst the most impressive feats ever in WWE. And right now, Daniel Bryan is talented and has
very
no answer for the Fiend, Bray Wyatt.
And
you also have to believe in many ways that perhaps the match
knees.
Is lost, just mentally. Before you even start the match against that thing. That's certainly a possibility, but Daniel Bryan may, if there's anyone... technically gifted
Bryan
enough to find a way, it would be Daniel Bryan.
Ouch.
As far-fetched as that may seem,
Bray Wyatt's got the neck cranking away at the neck of Daniel
Bryan. Incredible pressure, just twisting at the neck of Daniel Bryan. Guttural grunts from the Fiend.
We're gonna see the slap. He just licked his forehead.
Torturing Daniel Bryan like prey.
Nice.
Toying with it.
Don't look at the hard cam Fiend.
Is that? And the Fiend is perfectly content just bearing down on this submission, just inflicting pain for pain's sake. Oh my God, I'll try to rip the head off the shoulders of Bryan. And laughing, almost laughing about it.
He is laughing about it. And Bryan sent back to the outside. He can't win the match on the outside.
Certainly disturbed.
What's the Fiend going to do now?
Potentially unstoppable.
Standing with the crowd.
This ogre now ruling the earth on Friday Night SmackDown.
uppercut connected.
Daniel Bryan with a bit of offense in the beginning of this match, but other than that, maybe Daniel Bryan has bought himself a little bit of an opening here. Close to an opening as Daniel Bryan has found since the opening bell in the initial onslaught of strikes.
Fiend,
and again, remember, Daniel Bryan, a count-out victory
Bryan
will not help him win the
dive.
Title. He's got to pin or submit the Fiend. There he comes, Bryan's last throw.
The Fiend
caught, though. He was caught by the Fiend. Went for Sister Abigail, and Bryan drives the Fiend into the post. Daniel Bryan now trying to pick up the offensive pace off the apron.
Knocking the Fiend down.
And Daniel Bryan's
in control. Brian going up to the top rope. Gonna jump on the Fiend. Please catch him.
The Universal Champion is down.
Brian just launched himself diving on the Fiend. I think he may have hit his head on something. Oh, I do
high risk,
Brian.
High reward.
Big knee connecting. Then he runs in the ring, jumps up the top rope.
Absolutely sure
and a big diving splash. It sort of a mix of a splash and a knee drop.
Back to the ring. Daniel Bryan, top rope. Fiend in the middle of the ring. Daniel Bryan.
Missed the drop kick.
Down goes the Fiend. Can Daniel Bryan somehow pull off what would be a massive, massive upset?
See Brian beaten Bray Wyatt before, but never the Fiend. The Fiend jumps straight across the Fiend. Catch on, give it. Game 9, that's him down once more.
The Fiend down again. The Fiend already stirring. Daniel Bryan is...
Yes, he is going up for a third.
Bryan's up top, and the Fiend is back to his feet. Yet again.
No, and third drop kick, and Bryan keeps himself up to his feet.
It looks to me like at the moment, Daniel Bryan is finally beginning to believe.
Looks like we might be getting some yes kicks.
The WWE Universe believes.
Chanting yes.
Daniel Bryan's going to have to do things, as you mentioned, he has not done before.
Yes.
The yes delivered to the chest of the Fiend. Look at the wind up for the knockout blow. Is that it, Fiend?
Yes, down face.
Is that it, Fiend? Down face. First, Bryan's got a tap.
Oh, the Fiend back up. The Fiend's back up.
That is disheartening for a competitor. Daniel Bryan utilizing old faithful. The yes kick to no avail. Did you hear that roar, that scream from the Fiend delivered to Bryan? Who yet again
kicked the head. Down he goes. And up he is again.
Back up.
The Fiend will not stay down. Saying, come on, Daniel Bryan. Using both feet this time. Bryan just unleashing.
He's got to die this one.
Bang, and another one to the head. The Fiend just eating these kicks in his head. Is he going to get up this time?
The Fiend on his back. Daniel Bryan
going to hit the head, stomps, he's got the arm, and he's just stomping on the head and base of Bryan
Daniel Bryan, the water, Daniel Bryan now attacking the Fiend.
He's ready to start yesing.
This could be Bryan's moment.
Yes! Yes!
Slowly back.
Yes! Yes!
Yes!
Single leg high knee, the yes knee connected, cover, one, two, kick out the two by the Fiend. Brian's still in control. The Fiend has risen up to his feet before Bryan can. Just taking punches to the head. The Fiend just tossing him back.
Bryan pops back up.
Bryan's reversing everything the Fiend has, which I'm not necessarily a fan of, but he's got him mandible claw from the top rope.
What's he going
to do? Oh, Bryan's got him in an armbar. Under the top rope. One, two, three, four. No, he broke it up.
Count of five, he would have been disqualified.
Daniel Bryan
would have
had a top rope moment in time, potentially.
Up he goes.
Bryan,
top rope.
No, and Bray Wyatt catches him with a big right. Sister Abigail. Kissing her head. Bryan versus Schoolboy. One, two, kick out.
The Fiend almost stunned.
And the Fiend catches him with a mandible claw in midair. That was just the sheer weight of the Fiend against Daniel Bryan. That is it. That is it. Bryan movement slowing up, and that's it, he's out.
The Fiend retains
just like that. Bray Wyatt is still the Blue Universal Champion. Go on! Still think there was too much offense in that match for Daniel Bryan. It did still show off how dominant the Fiend is, though, so yeah.
Fight by Daniel Bryan
right.
Tonight, but in the end, the Fiend.
And the ref
just
running
Bryan
away.
Daniel Bryan utilized every maneuver he could think up in the heat of battle. He even rallied the yes movement for the first time in months and months. But even with the WWE Universe behind him, Daniel Bryan unable to dethrone.